Thank you so much, Tyzo. Yes, I think this is terribly important and want folks to really pay attention over the next few minutes. We welcome in a good friend of mine. This would be Reverend Al Miles to talk a little bit about this is an issue that affects not just men, not just it affects an entire community. We're talking about domestic violence. Help me define domestic violence, and folks out there who maybe aren't aware, what is domestic violence?
Well, Jai, it's a pattern of assaultative and abusive behavior. And in that pattern, perpetrators use coercion, deception, harassment, humiliation, and force to get what they want when they want it. It's important to note that it's a pattern. It's not about somebody losing it, not about somebody snapping, not about somebody being filled with Satan. It's a pattern of intentional, willful violence.
Some of the things that folks should look out for. Six, seven weeks ago, I sort of took a stand here, and I did get email that was on the negative side. Who are the victims in this? I know that it affects both sexes, but predominantly, who are the victims in this?
It's a gender-based crime. Even though there are men who are abused by women in heterosexual relationships, and some men abused by other men in homosexual relationships, 90% of the victim survivors are female, and more than 90% of the batterers are male. So it is gender-based, and I get that a lot too. What about all the men? Definitely there are men who are violated, but most of the violation are done by men against women. And I want to thank you for your bold stand against domestic violence, especially as a man. Thank you for doing that.
You know what? It's something that, and I know we've talked about this before, for all the guys out there, and I know you've written a few different books that we have here. What would you say to young men? Because I know you address them, and those are the young people who can truly make a difference. You know, one of the most empowering things, and I know you'll appreciate this, I shaved my head because I'd had a friend who was killed due to domestic violence. One of the neatest things I got was I had a cadet from the United States Military Academy, a young man, write me an email, and I told him, you're the future.
You're the ones who
could help impact this. And they really are, right? Young men out there who are listening to us, they're the ones who can make a difference.
That's right. That's right. It's important that you and I'm way older than you, it's important that we set the stage for the younger man to come along to take up the mantle. Women have been doing this issue alone forever, and we need to have men stand and be bold. There are a lot of young men now to say, what can I do, Reverend Miles? And I say, you can join the struggle by being respectful, not only to women, but also to men, to be respectful to each other. It's very important for men to be involved.
We're going to talk in a little bit more about this and everything, but if a young lady is in a relationship that's troubled, advice you would have for her?
I would say to not settle on that. There's no excuse for abuse. Young women will come to me a lot of times and say, I know he was just upset. I know he was angry. I know he had a little bit too much to drink. None of these cause domestic violence. It's intentional, and I would say do not settle. And please, please, when you're friends of this young woman, don't tell her, you know, you've got to stop. You've got to worry about and watch what you do around him, because if you do, you're going to set him off. It's not about setting him off. It's about him choosing to be violent. It's a choice.
Reverend Miles, if you don't mind sticking around, because I know this time of the year also is a critical time of year.
Absolutely.
When we talk about this, it causes so much trouble to the family and everything. If you don't mind, stick around another 30 minutes or so. We'll
love
ask
to.
A few more questions.
Thank you, Jai.
Thank you, Reverend.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.